Welcome to this software testing tutorial on test cases in manual testing and test cases in software testing. I will show you how to write test cases in manual testing with example. I will write example test cases for login page and test cases for Amazon website using TestCase Studio tool, that is a recorder plugin. What is test case in software testing? In a test case, you have the steps, test data to run those steps, and optionally, you may have expected results and even screenshots. If the expected results are obvious for a step, you may leave it blank, else you may list all the expected results. Screenshots are useful to remember the exact step or multiple expected results. In this tutorial, I will show you how to write test cases in real time using TestCase Studio, that is a test case generator. It writes test cases automatically in easy to understand plain English sentences. Therefore, these test cases are easy to run and easy to edit because of short sentences and have less mistakes because the test case recorder records all steps automatically. TestCase Studio records user actions in the browser. It is basically a web browser recorder plugin or extension. This means that it can generate test cases for web applications only. TestCase Studio is free and you can use it for automatic test case writing. TestCase Studio is different to Selenium IDE because it records not commands but plain English sentences. And TestCase Studio does not play back the test case. You still have to run the test case manually. Here are some names of test cases for login page. In Amazon, login is called sign in. I've listed these login test cases or login page test cases for the Amazon website. This is the Amazon website, and in order to log in, I have to click on sign in. And here you can see that the user can sign in using the email or mobile phone number, and there is an option for forgot password also. I've listed the test cases for login page or sign in page in Amazon. So the first test case is that the user should be able to sign in with an valid email. Also, the user should be able to sign in with a valid phone number. Then it is possible that the user forgot the password. It should be possible for the user to set the new password using email. Also, verify forgot password using the phone number. There is a checkbox on the login page that says keep me signed in. So that can also be verified in a test case. Then if the user enters invalid email, then the test case can be to verify that the user is not signed in. If the user enters a valid email but an invalid password, then also verify that the user is not signed in. And also verify logout. Now these test cases include positive and negative test cases for login page. The green highlighted test cases are positive test cases, meaning that they should run perfectly. The red highlighted test cases are negative test cases for login page, meaning that they should result in errors. Now, how to write test cases for login page? Let me select sign in with valid email, verify invalid email is not signed in, and verify valid email and invalid password is not signed in. I can combine these into a single test case because the steps are related to one another. First, I need TestCase Studio install. So TestCase Studio is available on the selectorshub.com website. I have put the link in the description box also. Now here we can read about the TestCase Studio It is a free browser recorder plugin to record the user actions performed on a web application in plain English sentences with screenshots. And it is officially featured by the Chrome Store. Now, TestCase Studio is available for all these browsers. Since I'm using Chrome browser, I can click on install, and in the bottom left corner, you can see that it redirects to the Chrome Web Store. I've clicked on that TestCase Studio link, and now I am in the Chrome Web Store. Here I have to click on Add to Chrome and click on Add Extension. It says TestCase Studio has been added to Chrome. It opens the Selectors Hub YouTube channel. Let me close it for now. And here, this is the extensions icon. I can click here and we can see TestCase Studio. Now I can pin it here. Next, after installing the TestCase Studio, I have to restart the browser. So let me restart Chrome and come back. I've restarted the Chrome browser. Now let me record the login test case for Amazon website and show you how to use TestCase Studio. Now first I will click on this icon. Now TestCase Studio is started. Let me go back to Chrome and paste the URL of the Amazon website and press enter. Now Amazon website is open. Now I can click on sign in here. And here, let me just put an invalid email. I'll just put in my name and click on continue. So this was a negative test case. So it says there is a problem. Now what I can do is I can put a valid email and then click on continue. Now it is asking for password. And let me put some invalid password and click on sign in. Again, there was a problem. Now let me put a valid password and click on sign in. Now here there are further steps. Now I can go to TestCase Studio and stop the recording. I can set the test case name here, so let me call it login test case. If I don't give the name of the test case, then it is going to just use the name of the website, but I have other test cases for Amazon website, so I can put in the name specifically here. Now in test case studio, there are many columns, like this is the step number, then this is the steps column, this is the column for the test data that I have used, and there is expected results. Now in expected results, we have to put our own expected results, exactly what we are looking for. Then it also gives XPath and CSS selector. This is used in automation testing for writing the test automation script, and it has also taken screenshots. Now I want to keep it simple, so I don't want XPath and CSS selector. So I can click to add or remove columns. I don't want XPath, I don't want CSS selector. So here it has recorded all the steps. The first step is to open the website, then click on sign in. Then it is giving plain English sentence, enter username into email or mobile phone number, then click on continue. This step is there, double click on email or mobile phone number. So this I don't need, so I can delete this step also. Then I gave the email address here and the data is also here. Then click on continue and it masks the password, so but it has recorded it. Then click on submit, then enter. This was the invalid password. So let me give the expected results from the beginning. So open website, this is obvious. It is going to open the website. Click on sign in. Enter some test data into email or mobile phone number, then click on continue. This is also obvious. Now I have already removed the columns that I didn't want, so I can click here to remove that header. Now out of these, when I entered an invalid email and clicked on continue, I can put the expected result that there should be an error, like there was a problem something. Then I entered invalid password, and then when I clicked on submit, here also I am expecting an error. After entering the valid password, when I clicked on sign in, so there I am expecting the OTP. Now after this, I can add steps also in TestCase Studio. So next step can be enter OTP, and the expected result is it should take to the home page. Now once I'm satisfied with the test case, I can download it. So click on this test case button here, and it is going to download it as a CSV file, which means I can open it in Excel. So let me save it, and it is asking for where to save all the screenshots as a zip file, so I can save this also. Now I have opened the test case in Excel, and I can format it in Excel, or if I'm using another format, I can copy the steps, test data, expected results, etc. into that format. And this is the zip file of all the screenshots. So here we can see that the screenshots are named according to the step in English. Open website, click on sign in, enter test data into email or mobile phone number, click on continue, enter this, click here, and they are also numbered from 1 to 10. So I can open these screenshots here. So it highlights where exactly the operation took place. Then here I entered some test data. This is the test data. So like that, the screenshots are also there. And one other thing in TestCase Studio is that in between we can have some steps, and we can click here to stop the recording and also to start the recording. I have listed the test cases for Amazon website, and these are also common e-commerce test cases. On Amazon website, there should be one test case to verify the home page. Then there are several tabs, each one of them at least needs one test case. These tabs are Fresh, Amazon Pay, Bestsellers. Now a very important test case is Search and View Product. Another important test case is to place the order. These two test cases are the most important, I think, because in any store you need to be able to allow the user to search and view the product and then place the order. And there can be other test cases for Amazon website to verify your account and verify your orders. Now let me select Search and View Product test case and write test case manually and automatically using TestCase Studio plugin. Now what I need to do is start TestCase Studio. So click here, TestCase Studio is started. Here it gives the instructions also. Now you start your testing. All actions will be converted to English sentences. For each step, unique selector will be generated for use in test automation script. And you can download the test cases or copy all the steps individually also. And you can update the file name before downloading it. So here I'm pasted the URL of Amazon, and now I need to perform the steps of the search and view product test case. So let me enter something, t-shirt for men, and press enter. Then I can scroll here. So let me pick this t-shirt here. Now it opens this new tab and I can select the size. So whatever steps I want, medium, and add to cart and buy now buttons are enabled. So let me go to TestCase Studio and click here to stop the recording. So here all the steps are there. I can just copy the steps also by clicking on this copy button, and these are the steps. But let me work in TestCase Studio only. So the test case name is search and view product. So first step is open website. It gives the data and then press the down arrow key. So maybe I don't need this step here. I can delete this. Enter t-shirt for men test data into search. Then here the expected results is that products are shown. Let me put relevant products are shown. Then scroll down and click on one of the particular products. Then here the expected result is the product's details should be displayed. That is one. And also add to cart and buy now buttons should be available. So these are the expected results here. Then I've selected size, and this way if I need more steps, I can click here and keep on adding more steps here. Now let me delete these for now and download the test case. So here the test case name is search and view product.csv. The test case is downloaded and now it is asking for the screenshots. Let me also download the screenshots here. So here is the CSV file that I can also open in Excel. So here is the complete test case. Now in this tutorial, I showed you TestCase Studio Recorder plugin and screenshot plugin. You can save a lot of time using TestCase Studio when writing test cases manually. I also showed you how to write test case for login and search and view product. Please subscribe to this software and testing training channel to keep learning about software testing and software testing tools. Thank you.